Documents submitted to COSASE by the top management of the Higher Education Students Financing Board showed very minimal representation from the regions of Karamoja, West Nile and Acholi, while the Western region dominated the lists of beneficiaries.
When you look at this list, majority of the beneficiaries are from Western Uganda. Now, I don't have a problem with Western Uganda. I have some relatives from there. Just like I have some relatives from Northern Uganda, like Honorable Akelo here. That's why I'm bothered that from her district, there's only 45 for all these years, yeah?
This dominated discussions as the Higher Education Students Financing Board appeared before COSASE to respond to queries raised in the 2021-2022 Auditor General's report. The list shows that Bushenyi, Busia, Isinjiro, Kabare, Kasese, Luwero, Mbarara, Mukono, Ntungamo, Rukunjiri, Shema and Mitoma have the highest numbers of beneficiaries despite the fact that selection must prioritize the poorest of the poor. MPs wondered why poorest districts of Karamoja, West Nile and parts of Eastern have the least number of beneficiaries.
If majority of these people, 330, Bushenyi, I just wanted to look at this the way it is, yeah? Mbarara 416, Ntungamo 488, Rukunjiri 305, Shema 384, and that many of these other districts you find 12, 19, 1.
Last year, Bundibugyo, where I come from, we got only 2. The factors behind this could be beyond the control of the Wanyamas, but the Wanyamas can do something to balance the equation.
Higher Education Students Financing Board leadership submitted that they received very little application from the districts with less numbers of beneficiaries. Michael Wanyama, the executive director of the Higher Education Students Financing Board, explained that they have been making affirmative action approaches to those districts with less beneficiaries.
As we do this work here, we also carry out analysis to find out where the systemic problems. Why does ABIM, for instance, have one? You realize that actually, I'm just giving that example, where does Amuru have those small numbers? ABIM traditionally has never had an applicant. But of course, when we meet a member of parliament, Amudat.
The committee also questioned officials on why they limited the students' loan scheme to science students and left out humanities students who are against the act that established the program.
It is mentioned that it will be for people pursuing sciences. So it's like now you are trying to do a favor from your statement to the humanities, when actually originally the scheme was meant for Ugandans in need, whether scientists or artists.
For them, they are comfortably implementing something which is against the act that puts them in place. I think we have a problem.
However, Wanyama indicated that strong preference had been pegged on the students pursuing science, technologies, engineering and mathematics, with very minimal presence of the humanities basing on the guidelines issued by the president, as well as the second national development plan and the third national development plan.
Whatever we are doing is for the good of this country. Amidst the little resources, how do you then choose who benefits, which programs do you award, and that kind of thing?
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.